Everyone, here is your English teacher, Ms. Fauzia Aslam from the Wave Private School. Today we will learn Unit 11, A Message for the Future, page number 108-109, book Family and Friends, second edition, class book, grade 5. So let's start. So we will start our today's class with the story of Professor and Chip. So let's listen and read on page number 108. Let's see which new invention Mr. Professor has done this time.
Listening 98. Listen and read. Does the time machine work?
Chip, I've done it. I've invented a time machine.
Wow! Well done, Professor.
The date you want to travel to is shown on this screen. When this button is pressed, the doors are closed and you are taken to a different time. I'm going to test the machine now.
Okay, Professor. Is this the future? You look so old!
No, Chip. The machine didn't work.
Oh dear. Sorry, Professor.
After listening to this conversation, you all have understood that this time again, the professor has failed in his invention. So now let's go to the next topic. Now here we will start with our grammar topic, the passives. The passive voice is used to show interest in the person or object that experiences an action rather than the person or object that performs the action. In other words, the most important thing or person becomes the subject of the sentence. Now let's see the passives with present simple. Here we can learn passive with present simple, which can also be called as present simple passive. In present simple passive, is, are is used with past participle. For example, number one, she is beaten by the police. Number two, they are called by the teacher. Number three, you are given a chance to win the game. Now let's learn the past participle of the verbs with the help of a table. Now here you can see on the screen, there is a table with three columns. First one verb, second past simple, and third past participle. Now we have to write the past simple and past participle of the given verbs. Now let's start. The first verb is take. So past simple will be took. And past participle, taken. Similarly, speak, spoke, spoken. Start, started, started. Fly, flew, flown. Catch, caught, caught. Now let's do the exercise which is given in your worksheet book. If you check in your worksheet book, you can find this table in it. So let's do this exercise, okay? So now all of you take your pens in your hand and open your worksheet and let's start. You can pause the slide over here, complete it in your worksheet, and then you can check the answers, okay? So I will just start with the answers. You can pause the slide over here, okay? So first one, speak, spoke, spoken. Now for past simple made. Its base verb is make, made. Give, gave, given. Grow, grew, grown. Cut, cut will remain the same as a base verb and same as past participle. Build, built, built. Now you see the past participle is found. So its verb will be find, past simple will be found, found. Drink, drank, drunk. The past simple is ate, its base verb, base form will be eat, ate, eaten. Forgive, forgave, forgiven. Past simple choose, its base verb will be choose. And past participle will be chosen. Now past participle is taught. Its base verb will be teach, taught, taught. Send, sent, sent. So hope now it is clear with you how to write the past participle of a given verb. And hope this table is also done by y'all. Now let's see some examples of passive. Now read the sentences carefully and see the underlying words. The picture is drawn by my sister. Stories are written by authors. The tanks are filled with water. French language is spoken in many parts of Europe. The Grand Canyon is visited by thousands of tourists every year. The baby is carried by the kangaroo in her pouch. A lot of garbage is thrown on the road by the people. My books are checked by my teacher. Now here you can see the highlighted word shows the passive form of the sentence. Now let's learn the active voice with present simple. The active voice describes a sentence where the subject performs the action stated by the verb. It follows a clear subject plus verb plus object construct that's easy to read. For example, many countries speak English. The show starts at 9 o'clock in the evening. To make this topic more clear, let us see some examples of active. The first one, my sister draws the picture. Author writes the story. Water fills the tank. Many parts of Europe speaks French language. Thousands of tourists visit the Grand Canyon every year. The kangaroo carries her baby in her pouch. The people throw lots of garbage on the road. My teacher checks my books. Now let us compare the active and passive sentences and get a more clear picture of the language structure. Active sentence, my sister draws the picture. The same in passive will be, the picture is drawn by my sister. See the same sentence in active and passive, how it will come. Number two, authors write the stories. For passive, stories are written by authors. Number three, in active, water fills the tank. Here, for passive, the tanks are filled with water. In active, many parts of Europe speaks French language. For passive, French language is spoken in many parts of Europe. Thousands of tourists visit the Grand Canyon every year. For passive, the Grand Canyon is visited by thousands of tourists every year. For active, the kangaroo carries her baby in her pouch. For passive, the baby is carried by the kangaroo in her pouch. For active, the people throw lots of garbage on the road. For passive, a lot of garbage is thrown on the road by the people. For active, my teacher checks my books. For passive, my books are checked by my teacher. Now here, this gives you a clear picture of how active and passive is done in simple present. Now let's read what is given in the class book. Read and learn the passive present simple. Use the passive when you don't know the subject of a sentence. Who does an action? Present simple passive is written with is or are plus past participle. For example, you are taken to a different time. Also use the present simple passive to talk about things that are generally true. English is spoken in many different countries. Now let's do an exercise on page number 108. You have to write A for the active sentence and B for the passive sentence. The first one is done for you. I will read it for you. Number one, computers are used all over the world. Now here are used, so it is a passive sentence. So we will write P. Number two, I do all my homework on my computer. I do, it is showing do. So here it is active. Number three, the film starts at 8 o'clock. The film starts, so it's active. A lot of films are made by Hollywood. Are made by Hollywood. So it is passive. A lot of ancient things are kept in museum. Are kept? Yeah, passive. Very good. We often visit our local museum. We often visit. So it is active. So hope you all have done this activity along with me. So here we come to the end of our lesson today. Hope you all have understood what is active and passive with present simple. Have a nice day. Thanks.